Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1823, Summary Table, grabbing a total row from each worksheet. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from David in my Fort Myers seminar. David had a series of 12 different worksheets. Each worksheet was for one expense, and at the bottom of each worksheet, there was a total row. He's trying to build on the summary page summary table that would pull the total row from each of the different sheets. And see, the big problem, so yesterday in episode 1822, Andrew was trying to grab always row 1 from every single sheet, or row 10 or row 15. It was a hard-coded row. Well, now we have the totals in a different spot. So here for AT&T, it's in row 42. For Citigroup, it's in row 50. For Exxon, it's in row 68. So we need to go find the total. Well, just like I did yesterday, I'm going to build a regular formula first that cannot be copied down. So we're going to look up the word total back here on the AT&T sheet, and we'll press or choose columns A through H. Now, I want to lock this down to the columns, and when I press F4, it puts the dollar signs before the A and the H. I don't have to press it 3 times. And then which column do we want? Well, it happens we want the fifth column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this formula is being entered in the fifth column, so I can simply say column. Now, I lucked out there that my summary table lines up with the columns on the individual sheets. You might need to adjust this by adding plus 1, minus 1 to get the column numbers to line up, and then, of course, false. Every VLOOKUP has to end in false. And we're just going to do a test here, make sure that that is copying across correctly, getting the right answers from the AT&T page, and so that is working great, but now I need to copy this down, and unfortunately this is hard-coded to always go grab the value from AT&T. So just as yesterday when I used indirect, we're going to use indirect again, but this time the indirect is only going to be used for the second argument of the VLOOKUP. So here, indirect, inside the indirect we have to build by concatenating enough stuff to get a reference that looks like this reference over here. So we need that opening apostrophe. So I'll put a quote and then right arrow to get on the other side of the apostrophe, another quote, and then ampersand. All right, so we're joining the apostrophe together with whatever is in D2. I'll put a dollar sign before the D, and then another ampersand. I'll delete the AT&T here. Opening quote, include the apostrophe, include the exclamation point, include the A through H, and then close the quote, close the parentheses for the indirect. All right, so this is pretty cool here. It's going to go take the sheet name from column D, it's going to append it with A through H, pass that to indirect, which will then tell VLOOKUP that that's where our lookup table lives. And so I'll press Control Enter here, and we get the same answers, but as I copy this down, then we are getting different answers from each of the other worksheets. Alright, so this is a cool use of indirect. Yesterday in 1822, we used indirect to always go get the totals from row 1. Here, we're using VLOOKUP to go get the total rows from wherever they are. Now, tomorrow, episode 1824, I have another example of indirect, but this is where indirect has gone completely wrong with hundreds or thousands of indirects, and it is slowing the spreadsheet down. And then in that case, we'll have a different way to work around. Hey, also, I noticed in the comments yesterday for 1822, let me switch back here to the 1822, in order to point to column 5, 6, 7, and 8, I had used the MID function with the column, and Excelarium proposed the shorter R1, C, and column. Column returns 5 and column E. Now, this is interesting. I'd never thought about using R1, C1 notation in indirect, but if you add the optional second parameter of comma false, that works. So, kudos to Excelarium for that great idea. Cool way to improve 1822 back here at 1823. So, we got a nice triumvirate of podcast episodes, 1822 yesterday, 1823 today, and then 1824 tomorrow to show you a way to do all this without indirect. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Andrew for yesterday's question, David for today's question, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast for Mr. Excel.